Today, we are always told not to reinvent the wheel, but researchers are reinventing it in completely new wheels and tires could soon hit the roads. A floating city in the Indian Ocean, the Maldives, one of the most beautiful places on Earth, faces a harsh reality of sea level rise. It may seem impossible, but solar energy can be harvested, even in the dead of the night. Hello everyone, the date is Tuesday, 28th June 2022. My name is Michael. Welcome to MW Newscast with the most interesting world news. Here are the details. Let's begin with new technology. Soon, flat tires could be a thing of the past. From the early days of automobiles until now, tires have seen many technological developments and advancements. Improvements in raw materials and chemical compounds have led to tires that last long and perform more efficiently. Despite the latest technologies, most tires are still pneumatic. They are a black rubber air-filled donut, first used on vehicles in the 1890s. For the past years, developers have been trying to reinvent the wheels, working on airless tires. There are already some in use on slow-moving vehicles like farm equipment. Now, developers are working in optimizing the technology to be used on road vehicles. The future tires won't need air anymore, so no more flat tires. They may even last longer and with lesser maintenance. But before entering the markets, for sure, these new technologies will need to pass rigorous safety tests. Even wheels can be reinvented, despite the old saying. Next story, a new floating city rising up in the Maldives. Located in the Indian Ocean, an archipelago of 1,190 islands, the Maldives is known for its clear emerald waters, beautiful beaches that stretch as far as your eyes can see. Such a beautiful place is one of the most vulnerable nations to the climate changes. Around 80% of its land area is less than 1 meter above sea level, considering that by the end of the century, the sea will rise by 1 meter. It means the current whole land will end up submerged. If actions are not taken in advance, then the nation may disappear and Maldivians will become climate refugees. To prevent that, the government of the Maldives, in cooperation with Dutch Docklands, a property developer from the Netherlands, is building a floating city of 5,000 units, including houses, restaurants, shops, and schools. When completed, the city will be self-sufficient and have all the same functions and utilities as one located inland, and will be big enough to house 20,000 people. First units are already being unveiled, and residents will be able to move by early 2024. In the future, expect to see more floating cities around the world. Last story for the day, new technology can harvest solar energy at night. One of the cons with solar power harvesting is that the current technology relies much on direct solar light, though there have been some advancements to harvest on cloudy or rainy days, but the efficiency is still low. Researchers from the School of Photovoltaic and Renewable Energy Engineering at the University of New South Wales, UNSW, in Sydney, Australia, have successfully tested a device capable of converting infrared heat into electrical power. This technology can harness energy from the sun in the dark of the night. They used a power generation device called a thermoradiative diode, which is similar to the technology used in night vision goggles. Even though this is the first step on this new technology, the researchers are very excited to move to refine their current device and create new ones with better efficiency, so that in the future, solar energy can be harnessed for 24 hours of the day. Indeed, good news! More technology that could cut off our dependence on fossil fuels. And this is the end of today's edition. Thanks for watching MW Newscast. Please click the subscribe button and please share the news with your friends and contacts. Again, this is Michael, and I will see you in the next edition. Take care and have a great day.